As we approach the business end of this season, retaining the Premier League is still our main priority. But with just a handful of fixtures left, I do feel that the time is right to make some changes again. Let's go and kick some balls. Hello and welcome back to Norwich, part 45, season 6 in the Ferguson Save, set in the future. And our goal remains retaining the Premier League title this season at the expense of anything else. If we do manage to win another competition, all well and good, but our focus has got to be on the 150 points that we can gain from winning the Premier League. And as you can see from the table, we are top of the league and we are 4 points clear of Manchester City and we are 6 points clear of third place Chelsea. Third place Chelsea do have a game in hand on us though, and as we go into the final 8 games of the season, I think the time is about right to make some more changes, and we'll have a look at those changes very shortly. But as usual, if you're brand new to the channel and you like FM content and you love to see people suffer playing this game, you're in the right place. So why not subscribe, like, watch, comment, do all that good stuff and help the channel to grow and help us to support the very worthwhile cause that you can see scrolling above. This channel has been set up to support the British Heart Foundation. And today we will be playing 2 games. We will be at home to Middlesbrough in the Premier League, and Middlesbrough at the moment are in 16th place. We are a better team than Middlesbrough and it's a game we should be winning. But it's also a game that, as we know from the past, is a potential banana skin. And then we will follow that with a home game against Celtic in the second leg of the round of 16 in the Champions League. But once again, I reiterate, our priority is not that game. Our priority is the Premier League. And so with that in mind, what I have decided as we go into the final closing stages of the season is that we are going to tweak the tactic again. We are now going to go back to the 4-1-2-2-1. And I do believe that it is time to rotate the players to conserve energy, and that will mean coming off the press. And one of the things that I have noticed about what has been going on lately is that we are giving away a lot of space just outside our penalty area. And so what I've decided to do in total and the tweaks that I'm going to make is I'm going to go into a low block and we're going to come off the trigger press, and in transition we're going to come off the counter press. This is to conserve energy and also protect the area just outside our penalty area. We are conceding a lot of space outside our penalty area there, and I think the best way to combat that is with the low block. And then in possession, we're not making any changes except we are changing run at defense to dribble less, and we are going to be more disciplined. Again, that is just trying to conserve energy as we go into our last 8 games of the season. And the intensity level, as you can see, of the tactic now is very low, and that should help protect the players and help keep them fit over the next 3 or 4 weeks. And so let's have a look at what has happened on the pitch since you were last with us. And when you were last with us, you saw us lose to Arsenal in the semi-final of the Carabao Cup, but we then went on to beat Chelsea in the FA Cup 4th round. That was followed by a 1-0 victory away at West Ham, and then that was followed by a very poor defeat at Tottenham. And then we beat Fulham in the Premier League by 2-0 and followed that with an away trip to Liverpool, which resulted in a goalless draw. A very good 3-1 victory against Leeds at home in the FA Cup 5th round was next, and that has set us up with a FA Cup quarter-final tie at home to Manchester City, and that is going to be coming up very shortly. And then we played at home to Brentford in the Premier League and we beat them by 6-1, and that was followed by the first leg of the Champions League round of 16, in which we went away to Celtic and we lost by 2-1. But it was only a penalty in the last few minutes that enabled Celtic to steal the advantage at this point. We are still in this tie, but it's going to be a very, very tough game. Celtic are a very, very good team in the future. And so that brings us very nicely on to today's games. We will be at home to Middlesbrough in the Premier League, and then we'll have that second leg against Celtic in the Champions League. In terms of our injury situation at the moment, we just have one player out. We have Plantia out, our fullback. He has torn wrist ligaments. He's expected to be out for another 4 to 8 days, so he's going to probably miss the next two games. He is a big loss, but we do have enough squad depth in order to cover for him. And so it is time to think about getting ready for this game against Middlesbrough. I do know that we find it difficult to beat teams who are struggling at the foot of the table. And so what I've decided to do is now maybe the time is right to play this low block, and that might just bring these teams out, creating space for us behind them and then enabling us to win fixtures that have become and proving to be very difficult for us. And so I have to go and get the team ready now, and we will be right back before the kickoff. Let's go and kick some balls. And so this very big game against Middlesbrough, a game we really should be winning. And the team for today is Gotz in goal with Kamara, Avbej, Lee and Allen at the back. Pasquale, Matic and Thomas in midfield, with Pook, Neil and Wilden making up the front three. Wilden has been out of form of late, and I have taken him aside during training, and I've had a quiet word with him, and hopefully that will be enough for him to get back into shape and to get back on scoring goal duty again. He hasn't scored in a long time, and this is a match, guys, that we should be winning, and I'm expecting a strong defence out there. We need to dominate the midfield, and I'm hoping that Wilden will get back into good form and that we will win this football match. As I said, we've gone with a low block because I think it's important that we don't lose this match. And if we can then just defend well and then take our chances when we do create chances, then we have every chance. But here come Middlesbrough. They've intercepted the ball, but it's picked up by Lee. Lee driving forward with a long punt over the top, looking for Pook. Pook with a header. He's found the corner and we have gone in front. It's Norwich 1, Middlesbrough 0. Absolutely fabulous start, and I think looking at the stats so far, thoroughly deserved. We've had 78% of the possession. That was a dreadful pass by the Middlesbrough defensive midfielder. Pook found himself with the ball coming over his shoulder, and he just somehow managed to guide his header past the goalkeeper into the corner. And that is a very, very good start for us. And so now we need to defend well. We need to just make sure that we don't give goals away. And the low block should help, because we have been giving a lot of space up outside our penalty area. We don't want to do that now. And we want to make sure that Middlesbrough do not exploit any space just outside the box. And we do have the ball, but Middlesbrough are coming forward. They're looking to get it down the left on the edge of the penalty area. Comes out to the fullback, looking to get a cross in. We need to stop these crosses, and we have defended it well. And the ball goes, and we are looking to break forward. And here comes Thomas. Thomas on the counter-attack finds Jay Neal. Jay Neal finds Pasquale to Matic. Matic finds Pook. Pook, looking for support, finds Pasquale. He finds Neil. Neil into Wilden. Wilden's in space, and Wilden has buried it. And just what I was hoping. The referee, I think, is going to check VAR, but that's a good sign that Wilden has got his shooting boots back on, but the goal is awarded. And taking Wilden aside, I've done this before when he went into a bad patch. Just pull him aside, have a quiet word in his ear, and he's responded, and he looked inspired in the dressing room by the team talk, and he's gone and made it 2-0. What a lovely strike from a brilliant striker. What a player he's been over the years. And it is now Norwich 2, Middlesbrough 0. We're well in control of this game, and hopefully now it should be 3 points in the bag. But there is another highlight, and it's Gotz with the ball. Gotz, he looks to fire a long kick up front, looking for Neil. Neil finds Matic. Matic to Pook. Wildon's in. Wildon with another one. He's hit the post this time. He should have scored, and we should be 3-0 up. We should be out of sight. And I'm a bit disappointed with Wildon there. But Matic with a curling free kick, which hits the crossbar and goes over. And we are totally dominating this game now. We've had 10 shots, 4 on target, with 72% of the possession. But Middlesbrough still going to be dangerous opponents. And there's a ball into the box from a set piece. It's picked up by Pasquale, though, at the edge of the box. Pasquale with a long ball forward, looking for Jay Neal. Can Jay Neal turn this defending into an attack? Neal looking to bring it forward. He finds Thomas on the right. Thomas, can he break forward up the wing? Yes, he can. He's bursting into the box. Can he get a cross in? It's got in. The Pook was almost on the end of it. We almost got another one there. And Allen is about to pick up the loose ball. It goes out for a throw. It remains Norwich 2, Middlesbrough 0, and that put us 7 points clear at the top of the league at this moment in time. And the further away that we can get from Manchester City and Chelsea, we'll put the pressure back on them. And this will be a good thing in terms of us retaining the Premier League this season. It's worth 150 points in the save. If we can do that, we only then have to win the treble. I say only have to win the treble, but we'll have 6 seasons to do that. And then the save will be complete once that is done. And there's a beautiful ball over the top. Wildon is in. Was he offside, though? The referee, I think, is running away from play. It's going to count. Wildon has made it. Norwich 3, Middlesbrough 0. He is back on the score sheet. And again, a beautiful pass over the top. Thomas found Pasquale. And there's a lovely run from Wildon. Delicate little chip into the corner. Now we are winning this game comfortably. That is exactly what I wanted from these boys. He was just about onside, timed his run perfectly. 3-0 to Norwich, and boy, what a start this has been. What a first half. And I'm going to go into the dressing room, and I'm going to say it's important to stay focused. And they've all responded to that. Even Gotz is having a good game today. And so let's get out in the second half, boys. Let's add to our 3 goals. Let's put the pressure on Manchester City and Chelsea. And there's a corner to the far post. Headed out. It comes out to Wildon. Wildon, who's on a hat-trick. He finds Avbej. Avbej with a drive, and it's a good save. And Pook, it's Allen who can't put it in at the far post. We are continuing to dominate this game. Middlesbrough, as you can see from the stats, are not getting shots on target. The low block seems to have worked. We are getting 50% of our shots on target. It's time now, I think, to make some changes and rest some players. And so we have made our changes, and hopefully now we will just see this game out. There's just 15 minutes to go. We do have the ball. It is Lee. Lee finds Ibaran. Ibaran looking over the top, can't find McSweeney, and Middlesbrough have the chance to counter-attack. Headed on, looking to be picked up by Kitambala. Kitambala, who has just come on, playing as the centre-mid. Ibaran coming on for Pasquale, comes out to Zaprapoulos. Zaprapoulos to Jay Neal. Jay Neal couldn't put it away at the near post. And it remains 3-0, but we do have a corner. Can we get a goal from a set piece here? One of our centre-backs, can we step up and get a header in on goal here? And Zaprapoulos fires in the corner to the far post, looking for Avbej, and cannot find him. But here's Kitambala. Kitambala to Pook, looking to get it onto his left foot. But something has happened here. I'm not quite sure what. Maybe Pook was offside. With 10 minutes to go, though, it is Pook coming forward again. It finds its way to McSweeney. McSweeney finds Lee. Lee finds Ibaran. Ibaran to Jay Neal. Jay Neal to Zaprapoulos. Zaprapoulos looking for Muntian outside him. Gets to the byline. Can he get a cross in? Yes, he can. And Wildon misses his hat-trick by half a yard as he puts it past the post. I would have expected Wildon in top form to put that away. But at the moment, we're still dominating this game. We have won this game. As it comes to Avbej, he finds Ibaran. Ibaran to Neal. Jay Neal, can he find Wildon? One last chance for Wildon, but it's been intercepted, and Middlesbrough can clear. but we should pick up this loose ball and lay with a ball over the top. I'm not quite sure what that was, but Wildon finds Saprapoulos, and Wildon with a header, and it goes over the crossbar. It's still 3-0, and it's probably now game over, but there are a lot of highlights in the dying minutes as Saprapoulos has given the ball away. He's won it back again, though, but given it away. Here come Middlesbrough. Middlesbrough looking to score at the end. We need to just hold firm now and hold on to our 3-goal cushion. We've headed the ball clear. I think that is it now. I think it's game over. We're going to win this game with those 3 first half goals. And although there is going to be another highlight, I'm not quite sure why we've had all these highlights in the last few minutes, but we have intercepted the ball. The ball goes out of play. And I'm going to check. Yes, we are in key highlights. Middlesbrough will have a throw. And referee, I think it is time now to find your whistle, blow the whistle. We have somehow got ourselves in a mess at the back, but it is going to be full time. It's Norwich 3, Middlesbrough 0. It's a very good victory, and it will help us to keep the pressure on Manchester City and Chelsea. Now both of those teams know they have to win their games later, or they will concede more ground to us, and then that's going to make it very difficult for them to catch us up. What a fabulous, fabulous performance that was. The low block tactic worked. I decided now it's time to ease the pressure on the boys, to come off the press and just defend well and then catch teams on the break. We did that, we've won the game, and now we have a very important game coming up against Celtic. Will it happen against Celtic? Will the low block work? Can we get the result and overturn that first leg result? I will go and prepare the team now, and we'll come back just before the kickoff. And just before we go to the game against Celtic, we do have some news that Chelsea were beaten 4-0 by Manchester United, and West Ham beat Manchester City by 1-0, and that means that we are now 7 points clear of Manchester City with 7 games to go, and we are 9 points clear of Chelsea, although Chelsea do have a game in hand, but even if they win that, they will still be 6 points behind us, and so I guess the title is within our grasp now. We need to make sure we keep winning in order to win the title now. So that is some very good news. Now it's time to go and play against Celtic. Let's go and kick some balls. And so the team for today against Celtic in the second leg of the Champions League round of 16 is Götze in goal with Muntian, Reguin, Raheem and Kamara at the back. Pasquale, Matic and Zaprapoulos in midfield with Aranda, Kitambala and Wildan up front. We've got to be favourites for this game because we are at home. We're just a goal behind. And Celtic have looked very, very tired of late. And at the moment, their team is looking quite tired as they come in to this game. I'm not going to say we should be winning this match. I'm going to say it's important we take advantage of the home advantage that we have. I trust these players and I'm going to tell them I trust them. Pasquale again is aggressive going out onto the pitch. He has an aggression attribute of 18, and every time he has a team talk he does look very aggressive, but hopefully he'll calm down once he's out on the pitch and use that aggression to good effect. And that's a lovely header from Wildon, finds Kitambala, and Celtic have defended it well. We're going to keep playing this low block now. I feel that it is the right thing to do, to defend well and then use our attacking prowess when we get chances. And if we can defend well here today against Celtic, then we do have every chance against this team, which is very tired. But we have played tired teams before and not beaten them. It's no guarantee, but that's nicely done by Kitambala. That's a looped ball over the top. Wildon heads it on, finds Aranda, and Aranda's made it 1-0. And that was a strange goal, but I do believe he might be offside. He, I think, was standing in an offside position when Wildon headed it on, or Pook headed it on. But no, the goal is awarded. What a very strange goal that was. Kitambala did well, took the ball off them, and Wilden's header, yes, he was kept onside by the left back, and Aranda has drilled it into the near post, and now that has levelled the score. And I don't think we need to see this again. We know that he was onside. It is now 2-2 overall, and we are back in this tie. We have actually never made it past the round of 16, and there's a curling free kick from Matic that goes over the crossbar. It goes out for a corner. What a good save that was. Can we get a goal from a set piece here? Zaprapoulos will look for the far post with this. And there's a header. It's cleared away and Celtic can break, but the highlight comes to nothing. We have, as I said, never got round past the round of 16 in the Champions League. It's proved a competition far too difficult for us to make any progression. I think this is as good a chance as we're going to get to go past this particular stage. And at the moment, Celtic have offered nothing in terms of an attacking outlet. We have had all the shots on goal. We've had four, most of them on target, or 50% on target. Celtic have had more possession than us, but we are creating all the chances. And here is Raguin. Raguin finds Matic. Matic, he finds Aranda. Aranda finds all the way back. It finds its way to Pasquale. Pasquale looking for Kitambala. Kitambala, who is wanted now and may be a transfer target. And there is, that looks to me like it's outside the penalty area. Zaprapoulos, where he is standing, is outside the penalty area. I don't believe that is going to be a penalty. And the penalty is being checked, though. I'm going to guess it's not a penalty. No, it looks, for me, a stonewall decision. He was outside the box. But we do have a free kick on the edge of the penalty area. Can we make something from this free kick? As Zaprapoulos looks to bend in this free kick. It's towards the far post. It's headed clear and goes out for a throw. At the moment, it's still Norwich 1, Celtic 0. Celtic, a very, very pacey team, are a very good team in the future in this era of the game. And the fans are expecting a win. Don't let them down. And I'm going to say you've defended well and keep going. You have the ability to make a difference. Go out there and prove it. And Raguan is a little bit distracted, and possibly he is a target for a substitution. I will give him a shout now from the touchline. I'm going to fire him up and just tell him that he's not playing very well and he needs to focus, and we need to win this football match, and not being focused is not a very good idea. So he is a target for a substitution, but at the moment we're doing okay. Raguan also is on a yellow card. I'm going to tell him as well to just ease off the tackles, as we do have a chance and Wilden has put it in. The referee again is going to check VAR. I think I wasn't actually aware that we were attacking there, so I have no idea how this is going to pan out. And the goal is awarded. Wilden has done it again. And it is now Norwich 2, Celtic 0. And that means that we are in the driving seat. And it will be our own fault if we lose this now. What a run from Wilden. What a finish. And it's Norwich 2, Celtic 0. And we're just after half-time. What a good time to score. What a lovely pass from Kamara. And Wilden buried it. And so now we are in the driving seat. And we hopefully can hold on to this. And I can see Muntian has suffered an injury. We do have to make a substitution. And we are trying to win the ball. And Kitambala has won the ball. Kitambala finds Muntian. I am going to take Muntian off at the first opportunity. And we will bring John Allen on at right back. And that's a lovely pass over the top to Aranda. Aranda in space, and Wilden's made it 3-0. And we are putting Celtic away here today. They did look tired before the game, and we've taken advantage of that. And it's now looking very likely that Norwich are going to get into the quarterfinals of the Champions League for the very first time. What a lovely pass, and Aranda's cross gobbled up by Wilden, and it's now 3-0. Wilden once again on a hat-trick, and we have pretty much dominated this game, deserved to be winning. Free kick into the box by Zapropoulos. It's hit the crossbar and it's cleared away for a throw-in. Celtic have not been in this game. I'll be very annoyed if Celtic get anything out of this game because they haven't even had a shot on goal, let alone one on target. I'll be very, very annoyed if we don't win this. And we have won the ball, and here's Kamara. Kamara looking for Raheem. He finds Pasquale. Pasquale finds Wilden. Wilden to Aranda, who's having a lovely game. Into the box for Wilden, but he just couldn't get there. And the goalkeeper manages to counter. And Celtic will look to counter. And they are bringing the ball out from the back. We need to be defensively solid. We have been so far since we employed the low block. And can we take the ball off them? Yes, we can. And here's Aranda. Aranda, who's having a spanking game, and here's Matic driving forward. Matic looking for Pasquale. Ball into Kamara, of all people, and it is now 4-0. We are destroying Celtic today. I wasn't expecting this kind of a result. I thought it was going to be a very nervy, edgy affair, but we have buried them. And boy, did I make the correct call just before this episode began, by wanting to go and play in the low block, wanting to conserve energy as we go into the remainder of the season. I think now it's time, though, to go and make some changes. And so we have made some changes and rested some players, because we do have the big game against Manchester City coming up in the FA Cup quarter-final, and winning that will give us a real opportunity to win the FA Cup this season. Although, as I've stressed all along, my main aim is to make sure that we retain the Premier League, and we are in a good position to do just that. The results against Newcastle coming up will be very important. And there's a mistake at the back, and Celtic are in, and Celtic have got one back, and it is now Norwich 4, Celtic 1. They have had one shot, Celtic, and they have scored. And I don't know what to say. They have not been in this game. We have had 20 shots. Celtic have had one. They've scored. It is 5-3 on the tie at the moment. I can't see Celtic scoring twice in the last 15 minutes. I think we just need to now hold on to this and make sure we get through to the next round. Zapropoulos curls in a free kick, and the referee is looking at a possible penalty here. I think we do have... No, we don't have Wilden on the pitch. I've just substituted Wilden. So we do have Finardi on the pitch, though he is the reserve penalty taker. Can we put this away? Can we put this game to bed now? And actually, it's going to be Flores who's stepping up. Flores of the penalty into the corner. Calm as you like. It's Norwich 5, Celtic 1. What a performance this has been. What a result this has been against a very, very good Celtic team. They came here tired. They're going away with their tail between their legs, knowing that they have been soundly beaten. And as we come up to the full-time whistle, Celtic may have one more opportunity as they are looking to break down the left. And there's the ball over the top. We need to defend it well. Raguan has defended it well. Zapropoulos finds Allen. Allen to Flores. Flores over the top to Pouk. Pouk is in a lot of space, bringing it forward. Can we get a sixth goal? What a result that would be. Here's McSweeney. McSweeney finds Flores. A lovely pass to Pouk. We are in again, but we cannot get on the end of it. And it still remains 5-1 to Norwich. Whether or not we score another goal is irrelevant. It's been an absolutely brilliant performance. And we need to make sure that we win this ball. Don't allow Celtic to score another one. It won't make any difference. It's 6-3 over the tie. We have won the ball in midfield. Flores did very well. Finds Kitambala. Kitambala over the top to Finardi. And Finardi has made it 6. We are really, really sending Celtic home disgraced. We are now 7-3 up on the tie. Not only did we overturn that 2-1 result, we have absolutely annihilated Celtic. Kitambala with a lovely pass. Finardi, without hesitating, fired it past the goalkeeper. 6-1. And what a result. this is going to be. We've done extremely well. Their goalkeeper has had an absolute howler, but Celtic hardly gave us cause for concern, only creating three chances. We, on the other hand, exceeded our XG. What a fabulous performance that was. And I'm really proud of everybody. What a result. We've turned that one around. We are in the Champions League quarterfinals. And boy, is this hotting up as we come to the back end of the season. We then now have to play Manchester City in the FA Cup quarterfinal. We don't know who we have in the Champions League quarterfinal. It's going to be a bit of a run-in. We are going to come back for the second leg of the Champions League quarterfinal, and then we will follow that with the Premier League game away at Wolves. That's it for this episode. And boy, what an episode it has been. 3-0 at home to Middlesbrough, followed by a 6-1 thumping of Celtic. If you are brand new to the channel and you like FM content and you love to see people suffer playing this game, you're in the right place for sure. So why not? Subscribe, like, watch, comment, do all that good stuff and help the channel to grow. Help us to support the British Heart Foundation. It was an experiment. I did decide we needed to do something different at this stage in the season. And so far, so good. The low block is working beautifully. All that remains to be said now is stay safe, take care, and we will see you in the next episode.